PokeClass is sponsored by CollectorsCash.com, your number one online store for all you need for the Pokemon trading card game. They have all the top competitive and collector's cards on the market at prices you won't find lower anywhere else. Whether you're after tins and packs from the current format, or just looking for those hard-to-get primes to finish off your deck, Collector's Cash is your place to go. Make sure you check them out at www.collectorscash.com. Hey everyone, and welcome to episode number 43 of PokeClass. I've only missed out on about a week's worth of information, but there's actually been a ton of new information announced. Typical, right? But anyway, we've had some exciting news about not only what's happening now with the new season, with the introduction of a brand new point system, but we've also had some pretty exciting news about what's to come later this year. So enough babbling, and let's get to it. So first off, let's start with the biggest news so far. We have a new point system being put into action this season. If you want to click here and view the video from two episodes ago, you'll see that I had that discussion about adding pro points to the current ELO system. Similar to what Magic did have, this made for players having more incentive to play out full events, rather than dropping to save losing points, and guess what? That's exactly what Pokemon have done. We now have something called the Championship Point System, and it's pretty much the same as Pro Points were, with a few adaptations for the Pokemon TCG. Let's have a quick look at it. So the ELO system still stays, which isn't the worst thing in the world when paired with the new system, since it gives us that feel of ranking still. The new system, however, now rewards you depending on how far you go into a tournament, usually for top cut finishes, and the best part is that you can't lose these points, you can only gain them. Let's have a look at these in comparison to the events happening now, Battle Roads. As you can see on the table here, you get two championship points for finishing first and one for finishing second. Pretty simple, but some of you are probably asking what kickers are. Well, these kickers are another name for extra points being up for grabs, depending on how large a tournament that you go to is, simply because it's going to be harder to get to the top if there are more players. Again, looking at the table on your left, you can see that a Battle Roads of more than 32 people has an extra point up for grabs for those of you that finish in 3rd and 4th as well. And Battle Roads with more than 64 people will mean that there are more points up for grabs all the way down to 8th place. This kind of thing is applied across all Premier events, and the more people in the tournament, the more points are up for grabs, which is obviously great. However, for those of you that plan on attending a ton of the smaller events across the year to grab you a ton of points, Pokemon have already thought about that and have placed a limit on how many points you'll receive for that event cycle, called Best Finish Limits. These limits are different for each tournament cycle, and keeping with the Battle Roads example, if you attend 10 Battle Roads, including both the ones at the beginning and at the end of the year, and get a point at each one, only your top 8 finishes will count, because that's what the Best Finish Limit is for Battle Roads. This will stop people collecting a load of these points in one go without going to the bigger events, and is a great method for doing this. However, 8 tournaments does seem a lot for us in the UK though, seeing as there are only really around that many in the first place. We'll have to wait and see about any changes. Another small thing to note about the Championship point system is that we can get them for Worlds when we compete there as well, which suggests that not only do we earn them to get to Worlds, but they could carry over from season to season to assure invites for years to come. Again, we'll have to wait and see how that pans out, but it certainly sounds extremely interesting and could provide more ways for players to compete at Worlds. Alongside being able to earn points through competing at events, Pokemon have also announced something called Play Points, which haven't been fully completed yet, but we do have a bit of info about them at the moment. Simply put, these points are in place just when you take part in an event, which can be any organised tournament, or even just going to league every week. What these points do is replace the player rewards completely, putting a new system in place for us to earn rewards for just going to events, regardless of how well we do. Along with that, we also get more points for attending bigger events, such as Nationals. For example, for attending a Battle Road, you might get 1 play point, but for attending a States, you might get 5 or even 10 depending on what they choose, but you get the idea. This new season is set for release in early 2012, and the official site says that there will be an FAQ about what we can do with these points uploaded at around the same time. So hopefully we'll have a better reward system in place in the near future. Another small thing to note about these play points is that a single player of the year will be announced every season for the player in each division with the most play points, which I guess is pretty cool. No prizes have been associated with this title yet, but we'll have to wait and see. What's definitely more interesting about the movement over to play points is this little snippet from the website. It reads, "Some play Pokemon events are invitation only, or have other restrictions or requirements to play. And below that you'll see the World Championships, as expected. There's also National Championships there as well." This is something that has sparked quite a bit of discussion, and is something I think Pokemon should maybe reconsider if it stays this way. What this section suggests is that players will have to have a certain amount of either play points, championship points, or even rating points to be able to attend your own national championships, which I find slightly strange. What this will do is narrow the field of eligible competitors for nationals, making them much harder events, but also makes them much less open to new players. Here in the UK, our nationals struggles to top over 100 players in Masters, and with this extra guideline in place, this could drop a fair bit, since there are lots of players that make nationals their first tournament in organised play, so I feel that this would be a slight mistake if it did go through. However, days are still young, and there are some creases to iron out, and I hope Pokemon give us some more information soon into what this section really means. Up next is a seemingly amazing change for players over here in the UK, and it ties in with the regionals change over in the US. Since we don't get regionals over here, the news that there will be two sets really didn't apply to us, but the tournament finder seems to tell us a different story. As you can see, there will be a state championship in Nottingham on the 17th of November, which suggests that we may possibly be getting two sets of state championships this year. This would be incredible for us over here, since that adds a whole new set of tournaments for us, as there are only usually around 4 or 5 states a year, which could possibly be doubled if what we see is correct. I find this to be extremely exciting, since it gives players more chances to compete in the larger events, and have more ways to accumulate points at them too. Hopefully we'll get a few more announcements in the near future about this. So after all this explaining, what do these points mean for the game, and why were they introduced in the first place? The main advantage to having these points is that players are now a lot less likely to drop from a tournament just to save losing a fair few points from their ELO total when entering a top cup. Even if a player manages to get to top cup and loses there, they'll still have accumulated that championship point, meaning they haven't really lost anything for deciding to go further. Also to do with this is the fact that if a player suffers two losses during Swiss rounds of, say, states, they may not feel like dropping and want to carry on, head for top cut, and get those championship points, making tournaments a lot more competitive, since players aren't going to be dropping before the tournament's top cut. The system as a whole just makes sure that players have no incentive to drop prematurely in a tournament, which is always going to be good for the game. As with any new system, there are going to be some negatives about the change, but I would rather call them mistakes or things to possibly reconsider. The main issue is the way that points are currently weighted. The points up for grabs at each event are higher or lower according to the K value of the event, so more points for Nationals than Battle Roads, but the amounts seem to be more fixing as the season progresses. For example, winning 8 Battle Roads is the equivalent in points to winning Nationals, and winning 2 Cities is the same as coming second place at Nationals. The Cities example is probably the best case for the points needing to be changed, since Cities are much easier to win than coming second at Nationals. This is just something Pokemon needs to reconsider, and even they themselves have admitted that things will need to change, so let's hope that this is one of them. So overall, there are still a lot of questions to be answered about most of this, including the big ones like, what do we need to get an invite to Worlds, or even Nationals according to the website. I'm sure we'll see a change in some of the workings of these systems, and hopefully they'll be soon, so that we all know what to aim for in this year's season. Thanks for watching this week's episode of PokeClass. If any of you are still a little bit in the dark about how these new points work, or how anything in the new season will work, please don't hesitate to ask in the comments below, or by a personal message, and I'll be sure to get back to you as quickly as possible. As ever, please comment, rate, and subscribe in either the bottom left or top right corner in a second, and I'll see you all next week.